Only three types of vectors so far we have learnt. Yes. Oh, sorry. Ashwin, you are there in the first class. Ashwin,
yes, ma'am.
You are there in the first class, Ashwin?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Okay, good. Then Ashwin, tell me, what do you mean by equal vectors, Ashwin? Equal vectors.
Two quantities with same magnitude and same direction.
Direction, very good, very good. Krishna Chandran, what do you mean by negative vector? Say in your own words, what do you mean by negative vector? Just now he joined, he's gone or what? Yeah, you are here. Krishnandran, say negative vector, please.
A vector is said to be negative if magnitude is same as second vector.
Yeah, magnitude is same as given vector, but
in opposite direction.
But direction is opposite. So simply you can say the magnitude is same and direction is opposite direction, then we can say it is as a negative vector. Okay. Shivani, what do you mean by collinear vector, Shivani? Collinear vectors. Can you say?
Ma'am.
Collinear vectors.
Ma'am, the vector are parallel to one another with some, with same magnitude or different magnitude. And same direction or opposite direction.
Okay, correct. So, two vectors, whether they have a different magnitude or same magnitude, if they move along the direction, that's the first case. Along the direction means all both are moving one after the another in the same direction or parallel to one another. Then we can say it's a collinear vectors. Okay, children. So, now we are moving on to the next one, co-initial vector. Next type. So, fourth type of vectors is co-initial vectors. Co-initial vectors. Co-initial vectors, that means both vectors are starting from same destination or same point. It may not be the direction or it may not be the same. There is no condition like that. Yes?
Sharon is in the waiting room.
Who?
Sharon.
I didn't get a notification of his.
Oh, okay.
So if you get notification, I would attempt. No. So maybe network issue. He will join later. If I get notification only, I can admit him. Maybe Sharon has a network issue, I think. No notification. Okay. So co-initial vectors means if they are both are starting from same origin or same point or same destination, then we can call it as a co-initial vector. So write down vectors having the same initial point. Vectors having same initial point. Vectors having same initial point. Steffi, can you message Sharon? Tell her to leave the meeting. Then again, means close the Zoom, open the Zoom and join again.
So, okay.
Then I may get her notification. Okay. So vectors having same initial point are called co-initial vectors. So that means suppose it's a point O and a quantity starting maybe two displacement vectors. Okay. Two displacement vector. A is starting here. Maybe B is going like this. There is not necessary that they should have same magnitude or same direction. Only thing is, they both are starting from same point, maybe different direction. So like that. So that is known as co-initial vectors. Okay. Yeah. Now I got notification. Okay. Now fourth one is coplanar vectors. Planar. Planar means they are in the plane. They both are in the same plane. Same plane. Okay. If there is no condition of same magnitude or same direction and all, but they can be the same plane. So coplanar vectors, vectors lying on the same plane. Vectors lying on the same plane. For example, write down. I'll just. Okay, for example, a velocity time graph of two objects on a straight line. So just talk about, okay, so suppose it's a velocity time graph. One object is moving. The velocity of one object is here, another object is moving this way. Okay, so we can say that they are moving in the same surface wherever they are. Okay, so they are in the same plane. We can say they are in the same plane.
Collinear vectors are also in the same plane, right?
Pardon?
Collinear vectors are also in the same plane, right?
Collinear vectors, yeah, but it may not be necessary. Collinear means what is the condition for? They are parallel in the same direction. Okay. It can be collinear in some situations.
Okay.
Not every time. Sometimes it may be coplanar also.
So ma'am, are all coplanar vectors collinear vectors?
It may be depends upon which dimension. Suppose it is a one-dimensional motion, they both are different. Okay. So for example, I can say that one bus is moving another road to some other place. Another bus is moving another time, but they are simultaneously moving, but maybe not the same places. Okay, so that may be a situation, it's just one dimensional motion. So they cannot be coplanar. Okay, so if you want to be coplanar, both the bus should be traveled in the same location or same reference point. That's the meaning of coplanar. Okay, otherwise some vectors, some will be only one dimensional motion. We cannot decide on any other direction. Okay, so it's a rare cases, not every time.
Okay.
Yeah.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, Gayatri.
Srihari said he's in the waiting room.
Yeah, but I'm not getting notification, my dear. Is the Sharon and all joined?
Ma'am, Sharon has some network issue, I guess. She told she's trying.
Ah, yeah, yeah. So that's a problem. So if a Srihari sent a message telling him the same reason, so just off the Zoom, got out Zoom and reopened the Zoom again. Hmm? Do you have the new link? You know, this time, today, sir has sent a new link, I think. Some are using old link. Any one of you know, so send that new link for Srihari where Srihari sent the message plus sent the new link. They must try to join the old link. That may be the reason. Okay. Both are Zoom, but now the link is new. So just send it and tell him to come. Join again. Steffi, you also try to share on same thing. Steffi.
Ma'am, I sent her.
Ah, okay. Because I have only 90 now. How many out of 26? 20 participants only now. Okay. Shall we continue, children? So now we are moving on to the next type. That is null vector. Null means zero vector. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Fifth one, null vector. Yeah, see, now he has joined Srihari. Null vector or zero vector. Null vector or zero vector. That means it's clear. A null vector or zero vector means its magnitude is zero. So that's the meaning. Its clearest meaning is its magnitude is zero. So a vector with zero magnitude, vector with zero magnitude. Zero magnitude and arbitrary direction. What do you mean by the word arbitrary in English? Anyone have idea? Yes, Srihari joined. So you can write the example. One is displacement of a stationary object. Second example, you can write it down. Velocity of a stationary object. It's very clear. Velocity of a stationary object means even it may be lying down. Maybe the object traveled in one direction and then after some time it comes to rest in that particular direction itself. So that's an arbitrary direction. Okay. Direction will be changing if it is moving. When it is stationary, there is no direction changing in whichever. So for example, we are car is moving on a traffic jam, and after little while it takes more time traffic signal to be move on. So that is the time it is in that particular direction, it is remaining stationary. So that's an arbitrary direction. So here what we have to look at, not the direction. In the case of null vector, the speciality of this is its magnitude. Its magnitude is zero. Okay. So for example, a car is moved and after purchasing some things, you went to buy a car, you purchase some things at a nearby shop and you come back to your house. So displacement becomes zero now. So that is a null vector in that case. Okay. So next one, unit vector. So all are there, Srihari, all are. So next is unit vector. So that is vector number 6. These all are objective type questions, okay? Unit vector, type of the vectors. Unit vector means 1. Okay, so its magnitude is 1. Then it can be a unit vector. A vector with unit magnitude, or you can write magnitude is 1. Value is 1. Whether it is opposite direction or it may be a collinear vector, it may be coplanar vector, any type of vector. Okay, so any type of vector, magnitude is 1. Okay, so in that case, it's called as unit vector. So we represent a unit vector value is as modulus A, it is 1, and it is also represent with the symbol like this. A you write down and there is a cap. So we call it A cap. How do we pronounce A cap? So it is a symbol of unit vector. Also, we can also get the value of a unit vector as 1 by using this A divided by modulus A. Because this is a vector, this is a single vector, and you can find out this vector's value as unit vector, as 1. So if B vector, if you want a B vector, if you want to get its value as 1, then we can apply that particular magnitude, particular vector divided of its own modulus. Or other way we can write, A vector also is equal to A cap modulus of vector. If you multiply 1 into 0, you already know 1 into 0 is 0, 1 into 5 is equal to 5, 1 into 6 is equal to 6. The same mathematical is applied in the case of unit vector. If a velocity of an object is 5 meter per second square and you wanted to have it's a unit vector, usually we find out the value with this. Just like this, modulus of this 5 into 1, 5. Just like this. That's the meaning of it. If you multiply with the same unit vector, you will get the answer same. So that sometimes we use in your derivation, A vector into A cap. So it's just a symbol that even you multiply with a unit vector with another vector, you will get the same magnitude. That's the meaning of it. Okay, so now we are moving on to some, I think, did you study vector algebra, all of you? Vector algebra, in that addition of the vectors or something. Did you study in plus one? No. Is plus one or plus two? I make it confused. So there is a portion vector algebra, maybe degree side. So little bit physics I heard, so we have to... little bit I have to teach. So what we have to do means, now we are going to do the operations with this vectors. We have to get an operations. So how can we add, for example, two vector quantities of displacement of two buses are moving in the same direction. You want to find a total displacement of the both quantities, then we can use addition of vectors. Okay, so like that, addition, subtraction, division, just like a max. So how can you find out in physics if the vector quantities, displacement one is 3 meter, another one is 4 meter. How can we represent this addition of total displacement? Already we learned in the first chapter graphical representation of the displacement. By finding the area under velocity time graph, you can find the displacement of an object. Now, if you want to find a total displacement of two vector quantities, or displacement is a vector quantity. Now, one displacement is 3 meter, another displacement is 5 meter. How do we represent in terms of vectors? So that is addition of the vectors. So first we go to multiplication, then we go to the addition. So next, write down operation of vector quantities. Operation of vector quantities. Okay. So first operation, what we are going to study? Multiplication. Multiplication. Why we have to study? Means some of this operation we may use. We may use to derive some theories in physics. Okay, regarding mechanics. So that is what why we need to study. Multiplication of vector with a number or a scalar quantity or a scalar, that's enough. For example, you know mass is a scalar quantity. We are getting an equation according to Newton's second law. Do you remember Newton's second law, anyone? 9th standard, first law, second law, third law. Aditya smiling, what? Anyone remember first law, second law, third law? Next chapter is that, first law, second law, third law, continuation. Vidur, remember?
Momentum.
Do you remember how much energy I spent for you, Steffi, when you are in 9th standard?
Ma'am, if I read it once, I'll get.
Okay, no idea. Did you know law of momentum? At least remember. Did you hear law of momentum, law of inertia, law of impulse? Did you ever heard about it? Yes. So that is what. So if you talk about according to Newton's second law of motion, law of momentum, rate of change in momentum is directly proportional to the force applied. That's coming next chapter, chapter 5. Okay. So in that, we have learned an equation to find the force. That force is equal to mass into acceleration. Where is the force? Is a vector quantity or a scalar quantity? Force is a vector quantity or scalar quantity? What do you think, Anna? See, some of you are off the video. Whether you are sleeping, I don't know. It's almost 1 o'clock, 1:30. So 10 more minutes. You have to bear with me. Anna? Anna Vijo? Srihari?
Yes, ma'am. Force is a vector quantity.
Oh, good. Mass is a vector quantity or scalar quantity, Srihari?
Scalar quantity.
So you are getting that equation. Force is equal to mass into acceleration. Acceleration is a scalar quantity or vector quantity, Krishnachandran? Acceleration?
Vector.
Okay, so we are talking about multiplication of vector with a number or a scalar. Actually, this is an example for it. You are getting a vector quantity force by multiplying with a scalar, mass and with the acceleration. Okay. Even you multiply mass and acceleration, you are getting the magnitude of the force without any sign of the vector. So why it is we are getting like that? One answer: when you multiply a scalar quantity with the vector quantity, you are getting a answer in vector quantity. So that is the application of multiplication of vector with the scalar quantity. Okay. Similarly, you learned what else you have learned? Pressure is equal to force per unit area. See, force is vector quantity, area is a scalar quantity, but you are getting pressure. Actually, it's a scalar quantity. See, division of a vector quantity with the scalar quantity, you are getting a scalar quantity. So all these are how the scientists are come to that conclusion of this answers. It is the implication of this vector physics. Okay, the study about the vectors, clear? So otherwise, what we learn in maths, positive, positive, you multiply, you get the positive. But here in this case, no. Forces got the mass into x. Both are two different quantities, but we are getting answer in any one. Either scalar or either vector. So that's why we are learning this. Clear? So we have learned F is equal to ma. Okay. Just we forgot about that. We will just go to that implications. So when we multiply a vector, when we multiply a vector, when we multiply a vector with a real number, with a real number, it's not negative or negative number, it's a real number, means positive. When we multiply vector with a real number, bracket, you can write either real number or scalar, maybe 2 times 4. 2 times 4 means this 2 is a real number. Okay, F is a vector quantity. In this case, F is equal to ma. Mass is scalar, acceleration vector quantity, you are getting a vector quantity. So that's why. So with a real number, scalar, or you can write positive number. We are not talking about negative number here, positive numbers only. Or positive number, we get the vector, we get the vector not moving. Positive number, we get the vector n into A. So that means vector A multiplied with a scalar. Scalar has no representation, nothing. So we just represent n as a scalar quantity, or it's a positive number. So A vector into n, you will get n A. And what about the direction? Even mass into acceleration. Mass is a scalar quantity, acceleration is a vector quantity. The answer what you get, force. Force will be in the direction of acceleration. Similarly, direction will be in the same direction of vector quantity. Can that write same direction of vector A? For example, you write example F vector is equal to mass into A vector. You can write it down in the form of a vector. For example, F is equal to M into A vector. Another one I can say, pressure force by area. Similarly, force is equal to pressure P into A, area. A means area. So I make it small, you get confused. I'll give you something which is not confused by you. Other one, which is the one we can have direction. One is F is equal to MA. Yes. I take it another one, momentum. Momentum P is equal to mass into velocity. Because in the pressure, it's not a scalar. So it's not a vector. So we can write pressure is, momentum is equal to mass into velocity vector. So these are the little more applicable.
Ma'am.
Yes.
In that, it is said, right, we get the vector N A vector.
Yeah, N A vector. What is N? N stands for this M mass or whichever scalar quantity you multiply. Correct. So okay. N stands for that physical quantity. This I am given as example. Example of this multiplication. This is one formula you are getting. Force vector quantity is equal to mass into acceleration vector. So direction of the force will be in which direction? In the direction of the acceleration. Similarly, momentum. Momentum is the product of mass and velocity. And force will be Newton's second law. rate of change in momentum is directly proportional to the force applied in the direction of momentum. That's what we have learned in 9th standard. So they are in the same direction. So that's the meaning. So this is an example. Why we are learning this? Because of this. That's all. Okay. And when you do calculation, what you do? So already you got a vector into n. You got n a vector. Actually, when you do the calculation, what are you doing? You are taking the modulus of this vector and you are getting the final answer n into a. Okay. When you do f is equal to ma, when we do f is equal to ma, we don't write the vector sign there because we are taking that formula, ignoring vector quantities. Then only final equation you are getting f is equal to ma. That is what we are studying. We don't study how it came and all in 9th standard. Now only we are studying how a scalar quantity into vector quantity turn become a another vector quantity.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Can you please say what is modulus?
Modulus is the method in max to find out the magnitude of a negative value or positive value. Okay, this is comes in statistics. You learn mod of a particular value, but I think you study this is in degree level. Finding the modulus or complex numbers. So if you write modulus of minus 7, you can write the answer as 7. So actually 7 is the magnitude. Minus only indicate the directions. In max, it's indicate it's a negative number. That's the difference. Okay. Similarly, integers, you take plus 25. We always forget about plus in a positive number. We just write 25. But why we are getting 25? Actually, you are writing in max is the modulus of the numbers. If I say 25 into minus 2, you will get the answer is minus 50. But when you get take the modulus, this is known as taking modulus, you are getting the magnitude. This is magnitude. Direction, this negative and positive sign is not the magnitude or value. A mathematics, a value indicate it actually doesn't have a negative sign, it doesn't have a positive sign. But you are learning negative integers and positive integers. That's why that branch integers come. We are treating it as separate. Okay. But when you come to the physics has important of magnitude and the direction. That's what we are applied that modulus here. Actually, it is from max. Okay. I think small classes you are not studying. I remember I studied in subsidiary max or what when I do physics graduation. I think that's the thing. I don't think you study in plus two also. Anyone have any idea regarding this? In max, are you studying plus one? No.
There's modulus function.
Ah, modulus function, but you don't do the application of it.
Only one or two questions.
Ah, that's all. Because it has, we forget about taking the modulus of all the values. Simply we just do 5 into minus, because max is the final outcome. Physics only, this minus and plus totally become direction. Max, we don't want this. Minus number is minus number only. We don't remove that minus number. But physics, this minus number always opposite direction. That's the meaning of it. Okay, children, so I think I wind up the session now. Remaining portions we can take on the basis of this. We have derivation coming up. That will be in the next class. Okay, thank you. So learn, this is objective type questions. Read through it. I know you are studying for your half yearly exam, but just read it. Otherwise you all will forget. Okay then. Thank you.